Sidonians, the Hivites, they dwell in the mount of Lebanon and Belhamon unto the entry of Haman. Listen, you don't, this mantle we are talking about, when it comes upon you, you jump the Jebusite. Are you hearing me? You eat the Hittite. Huh? You take the Canaanites. You move your way through. You don't wait. You move your way through. When they don't want to move, you move them. That's the first stage. As you enter into Christianity, you must start growing spiritually into warfare. Learning how to wake up, rise up and pray. Learning how to fast. Learning how to use the power of sacrifice. Are you understanding what I'm telling you now? This is the first stage. The first stage. So if you are not yet there, that means you have not yet begun the four stages. So you must understand that stage one, you will be tested, and you will be tested with contention. You will be tested with persecution. You will be tested with conflicts. He said, why me? So when you see these things are happening around you, know that you are in the first stage. And what you do, you build yourself there so that you can move from there to the next stage. Now we are talking about four stages that every believer must pass through if they must receive the battle mantle to enjoy lasting victory. Stage number two. Can I give you stage number two? Stage number two. Stage number two. Stage number two. Stage number two is Gigal. Gigal. G-I-L-G-A-L. Gigal. 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 Second Kings. Gigal. 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 Second Kings. Let me give you the main scripture. Second Kings chapter. Chapter. So Second Kings, oh. Yes, Second Kings chapter 19:9. See First Kings chapter 19 also. Hallelujah. I want to get the main scripture for you. Isaiah. Okay, Second Kings chapter 2. Second Kings chapter 2. 2 Kings chapter 2. Second Kings chapter 2. Let's begin to read from verse 1. Let's begin to read from verse 1. Let's begin to read from verse 1. Verse 1. Okay. Let me show you now. 2 Kings chapter 2. From verse 1. He said, and it came to pass when the Lord would take up Elijah unto heaven by a whirlwind, that Elijah went with Elisha from where? Gigal. Somebody say Gigal. Say Gigal. Say where? Say Gigal. Now, listen to this. Verse 2. And Elijah said unto Elisha, tarry here, I pray thee, for the Lord has sent me to Bethel. And Elisha said unto him, as the Lord liveth, and as thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee. So they went down to Bethel. But they started from where? Gigal, okay? Now, the stage two, somebody says stage two. Gigal, Gigal, at Gigal, you have spiritual activity with no power. That stage, stage number two, is the place of what? Spiritual activity with no power. We have religious ceremony with no power. No power to change anything. In this realm, knowledge and protocol are celebrated. Stage two is what? Gigal. At the place of Gigal, we say there's what? The place of religious activity without power. The place of religious activity without power. So, two things are celebrated there. What is celebrated there?
Knowledge
and what? Protocol. You enter there, everybody have big title. Doctor, doctor. Right, Reverend Doctor. And everybody there is well educated. I don't have anything against education. Education is good. Okay? And then we say the next thing is protocol. Before you can do this, protocol. But the knowledge and all the protocol, there is nothing that you can see that relates to power. Power to change lives. Power to convict the souls of men to be saved from their sin. Power to heal the sick and raise the dead. Power to bring deliverance upon God's people. You don't find it. We have what we call religious activity. People go to church because they are committed to go to church, but there's no commitment and relationship with God. Religious activity. Let people just know that I'm going to church. I don't want them to feel that if I stop going to church now, they will say something is happening to me now. And if something is happening to me now, they will start asking me any question. No, that is the stage of giga. So if you find yourself in giga, understand what is happening to you. You are doing religious activity without power. There's no conviction of your relationship with God, your fellowship with God, your interaction with God. Are you hearing me now? You are only doing it because it is mere responsibility. I don't want them to look at me somehow, because if I stop coming to church now, they will start calling. Sister Priscilla, we have not seen you in church for 5 Sundays. What is happening? Have you left the church? No. Okay, have you backslidden? No. Okay, then what is it? We have not seen you in church. So you just come to church so that they can say, we saw her in church. So that you are trying to actually avoid questions. You are trying to avoid too many interference with your life. So you just attend service because you don't want people to start looking for you and asking you questions. It's the stage of religious activity without power. You say you are a child of God, but your life carries no power. Listen, you are not permitted to be a witness of Jesus Christ until you are endued with power. Jesus said to the disciples in Acts chapter 1 and verse 8, he said, wait for me until you receive the Holy Ghost. He said, and when the Holy Ghost shall come upon you, you shall receive power. Is God speaking to somebody now? We set up worship concept just to sing and worship, but there's nothing in it. It's dry and empty. Why? Because the people that are committed to it, they have no connection with God. So it's religious activity without no power. Look at what the Bible says in 2 Timothy chapter 3 and verse 5. Let's look at it. 2 Timothy chapter 3 and verse 5. 2 Timothy chapter 3 and verse 5. 2 Timothy 3 and verse 5. 2 Timothy 3 and verse 5. Giga, the stage of religious activity without power, is when church becomes an organization. Are you understanding now? It's when church becomes an organization. Your message is structured. We have to see your message. This one after, what are you preaching? What are you saying? It's an organization. The Spirit of God is not there. It's only the flesh of men that are ruling. Religious activity without power. Look at what the Bible says. A form of godliness, but deny the power thereof, for such a pass away. Say, from such, do what? Turn away. Repent. Because God is not interested in religious activities, so ceremony. Let's follow the ceremony. You enter church, you are checking your time. I want to know, when are we living here? In the supernatural, there is nothing like time. Are you understanding? In the supernatural, there is nothing like time.